The scripture says, Jesus endured the pain of the cross, looking forward to the joy that was coming. When he was being mocked by the soldiers, beaten with whips, nailed on the cross, he was at a deficit. It looked like the enemy got the best of him. People thought if he is who he really said he is, he'd come down off that cross. He wouldn't be up there defeated. All the circumstances said he was done, but God has the final say. He won't let you get in a problem that he can't bring you out of. The odds may be against you, but the Most High God is for you. On the cross, Jesus said, "My God, why have you forsaken me?" There will be times where it feels like God has forgotten about you. Why did this bad break happen? Why did this person leave? Why did the pandemic hit, slow my business down? If you judge your life by where you are right now, you'll get discouraged, give up on dreams. It's because you're only putting your history on the scale. You're way out of balance. What you're missing is what's coming. You have to endure some things looking forward to the joy that's on the way. You have to know that God is still on the throne, that he's ordering your steps, that what he started, he's going to finish. No bad break can stop him. No person, no pandemic, no loss, no sickness. He sees what's not fair. He sees what didn't work out, the lonely nights, the times you feel forgotten. The psalmist said, "Weeping may endure for a night, but joy is coming in the morning." Jesus died on the cross. The forces of darkness celebrated, thought they had finally won. But on the third day, God said, "I don't think so. My son is not going to end in a deficit. He arose and is alive with all power." The point is, he had to go through some things to fulfill his purpose. I'd rather God make it easy, just float through life with all good breaks, but that's not how it works. You can't become all you were created to be without opposition. Things you don't understand, people that turn on you, times it looks like you're done. The way to endure is to keep reminding yourself that what God has in your future is not just going to make up for what you've been through, not just bring you back to even, but God is going to bring you out better, increased, promoted, healthier, to new levels of your destiny. He's designed your life to where the good things in your future will outweigh the negative things in your past. The scripture puts it this way, God has taken you from glory to glory. The path of the righteous gets brighter and brighter. He already has a solution to the problem that's holding you back. He's already arranged restoration for that loss, a new beginning for that setback, promotion for that injustice. It's already on the schedule. It's just a matter of time before you see the scales tip in your favor. When those lies come saying God has forgotten about you, it's never going to work out, you've seen your best days, just say, "No thanks. I know a secret. This may be difficult, it's not fair, but this is not how my story ends. Favor is in my future. Good breaks are headed my way. The right people are tracking me down." Thanks so much for watching today. If you want to see the full message, click the link in the description or go to joelosteen.com. We are praying for you and your family. It's going to be an awesome year. You wouldn't be alive unless God had something amazing up in front of you.
Stay in faith. We know God's got something amazing in store for you and your family. We'll see you next time.